Good evening. Welcome to Main Carnival Hall, and thank you for joining us. For the enjoyment of all patrons, photography and recordings are not permitted during the performance. To view photos and video content for many of our ensembles and guest performers, we encourage you to follow the School of Music on social media. Please take this moment to silence your phones and electronic devices. If you will be viewing the digital program on your phone, please decrease the brightness and consideration of those around you. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. Finally, please take this moment to locate your nearest available exit, which may be different from the entrance you used. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
My name is Douglas Lora Las Casas. I run the guitar department here since last August. And I'm very pleased and honored to introduce our guest artist. But before, I want to invite you all for our departmental recital on May 1st. That's a Wednesday night as well. In 2 weeks, 3 weeks, May 1st, we're going to have the amazing guitar students here playing chamber music and also the guitar orchestra. That is a special concert because we're going to have the mandolin player, Eva Skoll, an amazing mandolin player. And she will be as a soloist for a piece that I wrote for guitar orchestra and mandolin. It's a concertino for it. So you're all invited, May 1st at the recital hall. Our guest artist of tonight, he's an amazing artist, an amazing guitar player. He is one of the most prominent artists of his generation. A full schedule of tours around the world. He won the most important competitions of guitar, including the GFA 2008. He teaches at the Conservatory of Amsterdam. And besides this incredible player, he's a very gentle person and a very generous teacher, as we could see this afternoon with the students here. So please help me to welcome to the stage Gabriel Bianco.
Being here, I'm very happy to be here in Los Angeles. I'm going to start this concert with a piece by Johann Caspar Merz. So he was an amazing guitarist from the 19th century, and I'm going to play a piece where he sort of remember his roots from Hungary. By the time it was a different political situation than today. It was Austria-Hungary together, a big country, and Hungarians were sort of a minority. In this piece, in fact, there is a lot of folklore from Hungary. So the Hungarian fantasy is built with little, very short sections played all together, and at the end there is a csárdás. Csárdás is a Hungarian dance. And what bring the interest in this music are the offbeats and how Merz use it in this piece. In fact, this is very similar to the Franz Liszt Hungarian Rhapsodies. So the Hungarian fantasy by Johann Caspar Merz. Thank you. Before playing the Ponce Romantica Sonata, I would like to play a short piece for you. In fact, last night I recorded some videos for a guitar Salon International, and I wanted to play again this short piece written by Abel Calivaro, compo, and I enjoyed pretty much recording it yesterday, so I would like to also to play it for you tonight. By Manuel Maria Ponce. He was a composer from Mexico. And in fact, he had a very special connection with Andres Segovia. Andres Segovia was the main guitarist in the 20th century and the first who asked many, many composers to write for him. And in fact, by the time, it was not so easy to find original guitar music. It was not like today with internet, with the scores, the editions, it was not as easy. And in fact, Ponce wrote a lot for Segovia, mostly in his own style, but Segovia wanted to extend the guitar repertoire and to create not only, he wanted to play not only the music from his epoch, but also from before. And he asked Ponce to write music in different styles. So he wrote in the Baroque style, he also wrote in the classical style, and for this piece, in the romantical style. So the piece is a tribute to Franz Schubert, even though I think the music itself has some connection with Schubert in a way, but it's not like a Schubert piece. It's very different. It is, I think, a very unique romantic language that Ponce created on the instrument, and you will hear some harmonies that we rarely have on the guitar. It goes into many, many different tonalities. It's really, I think, harmonically and melodically one of the most amazing pieces of the 20th century written for the guitar. So the piece is in four movements. First is a usual Allegro sonata 4. The second movement is the slow movement, very beautiful melody. The third is called Moment Musical, which is a real tribute to Franz Schubert. Piece is called in the same way, which is like a scherzo, let's say. And the last movement is the final. So, Sonata Romantica by Manuel Maria Ponce. After this piece will be a little intermission. Thank you. important part with four pieces by Agustin Barrios. Those are four pieces that I was playing when I was a teenager. And so it reminds me a bit my youth. So this is, in fact, all of this music is very, very nostalgic in general. Agustin Barrios was, of course, he was from Paraguay, but the music he writes, in my opinion, is purely romantic music. There are a little bit of folklore influence sometimes, but the main idea is romanticism, in my opinion. So I will start with a prelude, short piece, very beautiful, that sounds almost like a just simple arpeggio improvised. Then I will play Julia for Florida. This is a barcarolle, so it is a love song that used to sing the sailors in Venice, in Italy. Then I'm going to play Choro da Saudade, which has a connection with Brazil. And in fact, saudade is a word that is difficult to translate into English or even French. It means like melancholia with a little bit of hope. And the last is waltz number four, so it's a waltz in the Viennese style. So four pieces by Agustin Barrios.
Thank you.
So the last piece of my program was written by Mauro Giuliani. He was a famous virtuoso playing the guitar in the 19th century. And this piece, in fact, most of the piece is not by Mauro Giuliani. Most of the music is by Rossini, the famous Italian opera composer. Giuliani was a big fan of Rossini, and he arranged a lot of his most famous arias. He wrote what he called Rossinianas. He wrote six of them, and I'm going to play the number five. So there are five different operas and different arias from those operas, but in an order that is not following the original work. But Giuliani made a big fantasy out of it, and it's like he tried to compose a little opera for the guitar. Most of those operas are talking about love, and well, as usual in Italian opera, or the love is perfect or is a complete disaster. So we're always a little bit in between in this music. So Mauro Giuliani, Rossini number five. Thank you. I would like to give a special thank to Douglas for inviting me. He's working here for almost a year, and he said that I'm the first guest that he brings, so I hope that, I mean, that was a nice moment also for the guitar program here. I would like to play a piece that is written for me by a friend of mine called Thomas Villotto. He's French like me, and we studied at the same time in Paris, in the conservatory. And at the time we were like, I don't know how we can call that here, maybe guitar buddies or something like that. And at the time he was living on a boat located in a district in Paris called Bastille. And this district is very famous for all the bars and nightclubs and all the things you can do there for the, let's say, the nightlife. In fact, this piece talks about a very specific evening when we probably enjoyed ourselves a little too much. And so this piece is about two friends coming back from the bars to their home, the boat of my friend. The two friends are very, very joyful, but there are a few accidents on the way. Thank you.